Welcome with me, Brian. We're now in my office, and we're going to examine this scarce mid-19th century children's book. It's a Moveable, Dean's Moveable Books. It's a series done by this company. They're well known for it. They issued all of these hand-colored books in the mid-19th century. This particular book here will be B3484 if you're looking to find it on our website. There are advertising end papers like so. The covers are a little bit scuffed. The spine cloth is splitting like this. The text block is loosened from the covers. There is an 1862 inscription here on the flyleaf. And I'll show you, I'm trying to show you here now how the text block leaves are shaken within the binding. What's interesting and nice about this particular example is that most, or actually just about all, of the movables function on some level. They may need minor repairs and adjustments done on the back of them, but in this version here, all of the backing sheets were just attached by a couple small glue spots, and these apparently have been dried or someone has removed them. And so now the back of each movable is readily available. This one here is come apart, it's in pieces, but it appears to all be present, and I have not attempted to figure out how to put it back together. But this one here still does this, and I think the arm would move too. It's just a question of examining this little mechanism, this paper, ingenious paper mechanism, like so. So that one still works. It appears that all the pieces are present. Looks like she's tickling him under the arm or something like this. That's pretty funny. And I'm going to show you basically every leaf and every image. Okay, so this one here has this little rat or mouse or something does come, yeah, it's a rat, it comes out of this little cage, and it does work, it does move, but it just needs a little attention here to be reattached. And this one here, yes, right, the cat goes up and down like this and the rat comes out. Okay, and there we go, you've seen them all. That's how this book survives. And if it interests you, it is available now online from me, Brian DiMambro.